Regardless of how you might have felt about this game in the past, things have changed very drastically ever since it first came out, and now is as good as a time as any to review it. What's happening, everybody out there? My name is Jakejames Lugo, and welcome to the channel. Now, if you guys have been following me for a while, you guys know that I'm a big fan of the Street Fighter series. I love going against my friends and beating down on them. I love going online and fighting against different people around the world. There's just something about getting into the ring with another person and just duking it out and seeing who comes out on top. And that's been the appeal of the Street Fighter series all throughout the 90s up to now with the release of Street Fighter V. Now, like I mentioned before, this game has drastically changed since it first came out. Things are just not the same as it was before. There's been a lot of different content, a lot of other updates and stuff that have really changed the game from originally what it was first released as. But regardless though, we're gonna look at it as a complete package and actually look at what this game has to offer right now in this day and age. So without further ado, get your gloves ready, get your headbands ready. Let's dive right into this. This is Street Fighter V.
Street Fighter V is the next big entry into Capcom's iconic fighting game series. Crazy enough, this game had a very divisive launch, mainly between the people who played it competitively and the so-called casual crowd. I'm just going to focus on the game because that's a discussion for another time. Outside of the talk around it, Street Fighter V looks very different than its predecessor, opting for a more realistic style with its visuals. Ryu and the rest of the world's warriors all look powerful, and the stages you fight in are pretty detailed and busy, but they're less cartoony overall. It's a pretty good looking game if you're accustomed to the cartoonish look that you get in most Capcom games, but it will stick out to you if realistic graphics are your thing. The roster is huge, with a lot of different fighting styles and personalities that will offer something neat to just about anyone. We got returning favorites from past games and new fighters that we've never met before, all of which have something cool and interesting to offer. The soundtrack to Street Fighter V might not be as iconic as many of the older games in the series, but getting more cool remixes for Guile, Ryu's, or Chun-Li's theme is still great in my book. The newer music is less impactful, with the exception of a few tracks that marquee the opening intro and the game menus. Every punch, kick, and projectile thrown looks and sounds like it hurts pretty bad, which is all I could ask for in my fighting games.
Now, one of the biggest things about Street Fighter V when it first came out is that it was super meager in the amount of content that it had to offer. Capcom was really trying to cater to that competitive scene, the people that were going to the Capcom Pro Tour and various other tournaments around the United States and other parts of the world, but it really didn't do a lot for people that just didn't want to compete in competitions and just wanted to enjoy the lore of Street Fighter and just enjoy the gameplay as a single player game. And since then, there's been all these different updates, including a new story mode as well as also character stories that really kind of added on to the meat of what Street Fighter V was, making it feel a little bit more like a complete game. On top of that, when Street Fighter V Arcade Edition came out, there was all these other changes that not only changed up the presentation of the game, but also added additional features on top of that, including extra stuff for the training mode, extra challenges, bonus modes, extra tweaks and stuff to survival, and other things that at first was completely unheard of when the game first came out. A lot of people were really disappointed about that, but ever since then, people have really warmed up to Street Fighter V. In my personal opinion, I wish that the game had released with something kind of like this. If Capcom had taken a little bit more extra time to put all these extra modes into it, I felt like a lot more people would have been a little bit more receptive to Street Fighter V when it first released. But ever since then, a lot of people have changed their opinions and stuff, and I think so for the better. But regardless of that, however, what do I think about the single player content and the story stuff with Street Fighter V?
When more content finally got injected into Street Fighter V through updates and patches, we got a whole lot more story than we've gotten in previous games. There's a general story mode that follows a plot connecting the events of Street Fighter II and Street Fighter III, with appearances from nearly the entire roster throughout. It plays out like a story that you'd find in something like the recent Mortal Kombat games, only with a lot less time spent with different characters. Though I appreciate the attempt to make a better presentation of the Street Fighter story, it doesn't always hit its mark all the time. I wish we'd gotten more details on some character motivations or additional interactions between different fighters we've yet to see interact much, but what we got here is still okay. Each character also has a small character-specific story that is tangential to the main plot, but these are short and pretty forgettable in comparison. In some instances, you only have to fight one time and you have to watch the rest of the cutscenes in this motion graphics type of style, which can be a letdown.
The biggest problem with Street Fighter V is that not only is it a story that kind of takes place in a wacky part of the Street Fighter universe, it's trying to connect both the Street Fighter II and Street Fighter IV days with that of Street Fighter III, but also a lot of the character motivations and a lot of the time that you spend with certain characters, you don't really get the full story about them. It kind of just assumes that you already know who these characters are and kind of just thrusts you right into the middle of everything. If things were handled a little bit more better, where how like Mortal Kombat 9 or Mortal Kombat X gives you a little bit more backstory and gives you a little bit more time to spend with these characters to get to know them a little bit better, I feel like you would have had a little bit more of a fleshed out story, as well as also a lot more interesting details to make the whole plot of the story make sense. Don't get me wrong, however, we always have to suspend our disbelief when it comes to a storyline with the Street Fighter series. Things are really out there, including all these different types of key energies, the Hado, you know, M. Bison with Shadowloo, and all these other organizations with fighters around the world. Now, I'm not really questioning that. What I am saying, however, though, is that if we're really going to kind of get connected with some of these cool characters, especially the new ones, including Laura, Rashid, and any of the other cast of fighters that have gotten injected into this game, I felt like we should have been able to learn a little bit more about them through this narrative plotline. And speaking of new characters, I have to say I really do like the designs and a lot of the special movesets for some of these new characters, including Laura, including Rashid, including some of the other characters that kind of get introduced later on through some of the content updates. I think that's pretty damn cool. One of the great things about the Street Fighter series is that every single game has a new assortment of fighters. Even though they have like familiar faces from throughout the franchise, you're always going to get that assortment of cool new fighters that you've never seen before that have also interesting fighting styles that make them stand apart from the rest of the cast. Whether the new fighters are competitively viable or not, that's up to you guys to decide, as well as the competitive scene, but I do have to say they are very fun to play, and they do have their little quirks here and there that give them a little bit much more personality compared to some of the rest of the cast that we've known for like the past 20 or so years. But let's get away from story stuff. You're not playing a Street Fighter game just for story or just for character designs and stuff. You're playing it for the gameplay. You're playing it for that fighting gameplay that we all know and love, beating down on your freaking friends and doing all this stuff. How does the gameplay of Street Fighter V stack up to the rest of the series?
The fighting in Street Fighter V is built upon the back of earlier games in the series. If you've played a lot of Street Fighter II or Street Fighter III in the arcades, you're going to have a solid base to start from. But even if you got into the series way later or never have before, you'll be happy to know that it's not incredibly complicated to start battling. The core fighting is the same as it's always been throughout the years, but there is some new tech to get acquainted with. The game introduces the V system, which incorporates the V trigger, V skill, and V reversal. Every character has their own V-trigger and V-skill that is tied to their super special moves and abilities that they can use throughout a fight, with a meter that builds up as you take damage. Ryu might be able to parry attacks and power up his fireballs with his V-skill, while Zangief might be able to soak up one random attack with his massive muscles and spin his body around to draw in enemies near him for a grab. V-skills and V-triggers can be different for everyone, and it's even more so with the release of the updates for Street Fighter V Arcade Edition that allows you to choose from two different V-skills and V-triggers for each fighter. The V reversal is very similar to a quick counter for the whole roster that uses a one piece of the meter, which also negates an attack and pushes your opponent away. Some might say that this is very similar to the Alpha counter ability from the Street Fighter Alpha series, and they'd be right to do so, but V reversal acts a little bit differently and could be very helpful in changing the momentum of a round. All of this stuff is somewhat easy to understand, but definitely difficult to fully master. But I like these new additions to the game's fighting. It really allows for a wide range of matchups and strategies for everyone to discover.
The interesting thing about more modern day Street Fighter games is that Capcom's really trying to blend both the old school stuff from like Street Fighter 2 and Street Fighter 3 with a couple of new elements here and there to mix things up and make it feel fresh. A lot of people that have played many of the Street Fighter games will feel right at home with some of their favorite characters, especially some of the returning ones, including Ryu and Ken and many of the others, including Chun-Li, Guile, etc. However, there is still enough new stuff in there with some of the new characters with their fighting styles and all the other extra new mechanics to make things feel brand new and kind of mix things up for both the older generation and the newer generation. For someone that isn't going out there and trying to make top 32 or top 16, this is still a game that is accessible to me while still maintaining the amount of depth that a lot of competitive players are really looking for when they play a game like this. To me personally, this is the most accessible Street Fighter game to date. It still allows people to kind of go in there, do a bunch of different special moves and learn a couple combos and still do well for their own right. But if you really want that in-depth type of metagame and all those different types of like tier list stuff and everything else that you're really going to find within the competitive scene, Street Fighter V is definitely still the place to be at, and it does it a little bit more so in a better way than previous games, including Street Fighter IV and many of the other Versus games that you would see from Capcom. Another thing I want to comment on is the V-trigger system, which is a little bit different than when the game first came out. It used to be just one V-trigger that you had with one super and one V-trigger ability, but now with Street Fighter V Arcade Edition, you have two this time to choose from right before a matchup starts. This makes mirror matches between the same character be a little bit different, as well as also all the different matchups for a specific character seem a little bit different and kind of change the momentum flow of a matchup depending on which V-trigger that you use throughout the game. But no matter what your skill level is, whether you're a pro player or a casual, you're going to find a lot of fun seeing what different types of mechanics and strategies you could use with the entire roster. So besides that, let's talk a little bit about the online play, which I feel like is a huge component to a fighting game, especially Street Fighter V.
Multiplayer is what Street Fighter thrives in. Online multiplayer is a necessity for any fighting game, so it's only natural that Street Fighter V would have a big online component. And it does, but there are quite a number of issues with playing games online against people around the world. I've run into many laggy matches and suspicious players online, even though my connection at home is very good. It bothers me how the game can allow me to filter out other players with bad connections, but still put me in a terrible match that's supposedly near perfect with 5 bars connection. I can't even begin to tell you how many times this has happened to me when I go online, and it remains annoying to this day. That being said, however, when you're online and things are going well, everything is all good. There's ranked matches, there's also battle lounges you could set up for up to 8 people. Finding other players isn't difficult either, since there's so many people playing the game online right now, and you can always find an open battle lounge nearly at any time. Connecting to other players you want to play frequently is good with the Capcom Fighters Network, but I hardly use this when I'm connecting to other people online. I'm honestly not sure how many others really utilize this, I didn't find it necessary at all, and probably would have forgotten about it if it had just disappeared. My gripes and internet connections aside, you could do a lot while playing Street Fighter V online.
Now, I have a love-hate relationship when it comes to online play with Capcom games specifically, especially in Street Fighter V. Every time I feel like I'm gonna get into a good series of matchups, I always find like a bunch of duds. I always run into issues with connection problems, lag, and other different things that pop up here and there that kind of affect my experience for the worse. It can be a real annoyance when you're just trying to find a good bunch of matches just to kind of play both in online ranked battles, as well as also casuals and the endless lobbies. Those things could be somewhat fun here and there, but every once in a while you'll find that one guy that's got that garbage connection or that you know is messing around with his connection somehow because he wants the ranked points in ranked battles. That could be really, really annoying. Whether this will improve over time, again, it's anybody's guess. A lot of people were saying the same thing when Street Fighter V first came out, especially when it was just exclusive to the PlayStation 4, but again, there's a lot of different stuff going on with this game, and to be honest with you, results may vary when you play this game online. You could say that about any other fighting game out there, not just Street Fighter and not just Capcom. There's plenty of other fighting games out there that have like different issues with their online connectivity. But for me, if we're talking just strictly about Street Fighter V, those are some of the issues that I ran into, and I feel like it is still a big enough problem even to this day that Capcom still needs to work on, especially with other future releases down the line. So besides that, I want to talk a little bit more about some of the extra content that came with some of the later updates with Street Fighter V, which I felt not only added extra value, but also implemented other stuff that the series never really had beforehand.
With the release of Street Fighter V Arcade Edition, there was a lot more bonus content that fans could dive into that greatly enhanced the game from when it first launched. The challenges and new trials for each character give you chances to master hard combos and earn additional fight money to purchase unlockables in-game, such as new costumes and more color options. Some of us won't complete all of the trials because of how restrictively challenging that they can be, but it's definitely nice to have them there for anyone looking to really get good with the game's mechanics. The best addition to me is the revamped arcade mode that gives a big nod to the entire franchise. The game has different arcade paths themed to different specific Street Fighter games from the past, from the original game back in 1987 all the way up through to now with Street Fighter V. Capcom even goes as far as to recreate the rosters, menus, and some of the music tracks from those games for each different arcade path to give you a window into some of the history of the franchise. It's cool things like this that I feel are fantastic and act as a big thank you from Capcom to longtime fans. The newer version of the game does also get some more DLC characters and stages that are periodically released over time. More content is always great, even though it can be a little bit annoying when trying to earn them from within the game. One thing I should also add here is that Street Fighter V Arcade Edition also has a gallery mode that came recently with some of the patches for the game. It could give you alternate outfits for characters, as well as also additional artwork and bonus music tracks to check out from the gallery. I honestly love stuff like this as an added bonus in recent fighting games, and I'm really happy to see that Street Fighter is doing something similar.
Now, while I appreciate all these extra modes and gameplay types in order to earn extra fight money and additional costumes that you can't normally buy on the PlayStation Store or elsewhere, it is a little bit annoying how difficult it could be sometimes, especially the grind when it comes to getting the required amount of fight money to get some of these extra things. And I'm not really too much of a fan of the timed exclusive outfits. I find like those tend to be way too short sometimes and a little bit overly complicated in order just to get people not only just to play the game a little bit more, but also just to spend money on some of the other outfits that are in the PlayStation Store and elsewhere. I feel like Capcom a little bit nickels and dimes here and there with that, especially also with the characters and some of the extra stages. However, that being said, I do appreciate them giving the option in order to earn this stuff without paying an actual dime of real world money. The other thing I also want to note is that it is kind of cool seeing the crossover outfits from other Capcom series, including Devil May Cry, Monster Hunter, and various other series that people are really big fans of. It's kind of cool to see that kind of love shown in another Capcom game, especially one as big as Street Fighter. But with all that being said, what do I think about Street Fighter V right now as a complete package? Should people be diving into it right now in this day and age? Surprisingly, yeah, I actually would recommend Street Fighter V to just about anybody, especially if they're into 2D fighting games. Regardless of where you might stand with the types of fighting and the different mechanics and the systems and all the other types of stuff that go into a fighting game, you do have to admit that there is still a lot of content, there's still a lot of love put into Street Fighter V, even though it took a little bit longer than most other games to get to it. If we were still at the launch of Street Fighter V and we didn't have all the extra stuff that we got over time, then I would say no, definitely wait it out and it's not worth it whatsoever. That's exactly how I felt when the game first came out, even though I enjoyed the fighting for what it was. But as it is now, with all the extra content and all the other stuff that Capcom has implemented into it, with all the extra patches, the updates, and all the additional content that came from Street Fighter V Arcade Edition, I feel like Street Fighter V is definitely a viable purchase and a good addition to anybody's PlayStation collection or PC collection. Even though you might not be a fighting game aficionado, the foundation that was already established by Street Fighter and in Street Fighter V that continues the legacy is still very solid. It offers a lot of fun times, a lot of great moments, especially between you and your friends if you're duking it out, and also a lot of great content to just play on your own, even though it didn't really have it at first. It might not be the king of the hill when it comes to single player story content. I still feel like that title belongs to NetherRealms with their Mortal Kombat and Injustice series. But Capcom still has the stuff to give us a 1-2 punch of gaming goodness when it comes to a solid fighting game that anybody could really get into. Anyway guys, those are my full thoughts on Street Fighter V or Street Fighter V Arcade Edition, however you want to look at it. I still play it from time to time, I tend to stream it every once in a while, definitely check out my stream in the description box below, there's links there. I love playing the game with other friends, it's just a fun thing to kind of pop in every once in a while. You can't go wrong with Street Fighter sometimes. But those are just some of my thoughts on the matter. Let me know what you guys think about Street Fighter V or Street Fighter V Arcade Edition in the comment section down below. Tell me some of your favorite Street Fighter characters or one good or positive or kind of terrible or annoying thing about Street Fighter V. Put it in the comment section down below. As always, don't forget to leave a like on this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel for all my videos just like this one, my other reviews, my podcast shows, my vlogs. I just uploaded a new one not too long ago. Check all that stuff out. There's a lot of great content that I know you guys are gonna love. And also guys, don't forget I am on Patreon. There's a link in the description box below to my Patreon page. I want to give a big shout out to Jasmine Russell for supporting me at the Beast tier level on my Patreon page. You're getting shout outs for the entire month on every single video. Remember guys, if you want that same type of love, you can get it too if you check out my Patreon page and pledge at the right tier level. There's a bunch of exclusive content on there for everybody that pledges. I try to upload frequently on there and share a whole bunch of different interesting gaming content and food for thought that everybody would enjoy and also get something out of. So I'm trying to give you guys a lot of value on my Patreon page regardless of the tier level that you pledge. Anyway, that's all I got for you, and I will talk to all you guys again very soon. Peace out, and stay epic, everybody.